ever have trouble focusing? If you are like me, at times during the pandemic, more than once I found myself having trouble keeping my focus. My mind was adrift. I had trouble keeping concentrating on the things I needed to accomplish. You know, there were too many distractions. There were too many worries or projects or concern that overwhelmed my mind. And I sort of drifted along until clarity was eventually regained. You know, throughout the history of the church, there has been a tendency for us to lose focus from where our affections and where our undivided attention ought to be. You know, in fact, the Apostle Paul says in his letter to the Corinthian church that our thoughts can easily be taken captive, meaning that they are often held hostage and therefore unable to be fully given to what Christ wants us to think on. You know that term, taken captive, that the Apostle Paul uses, it's actually a military term that he puts into the text here. And it indicates that there is a coordinated spiritual strategy that is being waged against the believer to encourage them to lose focus on some of the things that God would want them to dwell upon. I mean, if you have a life like mine, there are many things that are vying for my attention and your attention. I think of my own life, it's my family and my kids, my finances, my friendships, you know, my exercise routine, my health, you know, the headaches that sometimes I have at the office, projects at work, and sometimes in the flotsam and jetsam of life that is kind of floating around us, it's hard to keep a Christ-centered focus in our lives. You know, in churches, it's very similar. It's not just in our personal lives, in the church organizations that we are a part of. You know, we've got things like programs and budgets and logistical issues, sometimes disputes, sometimes different doctrines that we are trying to emphasize or we become enamored with, different approaches on how we ought to do church or different styles that we have. But Paul gives the churches in Asia Minor this reminder in Colossians chapter 2, verse 6 and 7. Notice what the text says. He says, "Therefore, as you receive Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in him, rooted and built up in him and established in the faith, just as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving." See, Paul first of all speaks about what they have received. Notice what the text says. It says, they received Jesus Christ. They didn't receive a church. They didn't receive a title on the church door or above the church doors. They didn't receive a style or the name of a good communicator or a dynamic personality. The text says, Paul says, they received Christ. You received Christ. Because Christ is the only one who died and rose from the dead and provides eternal life to anyone who would believe on him. So Paul reminds them, you received Christ. But then Paul transitions and says, as you have received Christ Jesus the Lord, he says, make sure that you continue walking in him and being built in him and being established in the faith in him. Notice the words that he uses here. He says, walking, building, and established in Christ. Let me look at that first word. First of all, walk. The word that walk that he uses here, in ancient times there was this idea called the halak, and it means sort of the step-by-step process that we go through in life. Oftentimes we bring Christ into our major decisions and we sort of pray to Christ or seek Christ in our major decisions, but that's not what halak is. Halak is the step-by-step process, even in the mundaneness of life, every step along the way, make Christ the center. Walk with Christ in the halak, day in and day out. But then he uses the word building. You know, we're building structures and legacies in our life, and some are building personal empires and riches that they will leave behind. Others want to build a family legacy. And there's nothing wrong with building those kinds of things. But Paul reminds us here, he says that believers need to be built up in Christ. Whatever you build in your life, and whatever cause you build your life around, Paul says, let life construction grow in Christ. But then he also says, now also be established in the faith. You know, I discovered the oldest house in the world this week that has been continuously occupied. It was built in France in the 1400s. This house is over 600 years old that somebody has been living in this house. Isn't that an amazing thought that the house is so well constructed, that this house is so well established, that it has been, somebody has been living in it for 600 years? See, the construction and the foundation have to be solid to have such an established house. A house is only as strong as its foundation, and Paul is reminding us to establish the right foundations to build our lives on. And if we are ever going to be established in our faith, we need to be firmly established in Christ. So Paul uses these words, walk, build, and establish. You see the point of all of this? The point is that Paul is telling the Corinthian church or the Colossian church that wherever you are in this journey of life and whatever situation you may be in, Jesus needs to be the center. You need to have a Christ-centered life. Put Christ at the center of everything. You know, this exhortation by Paul applies both individually as individual people of God in our relationship with God's and our personal relationship with God. But it also applies to our corporate practice as a church. You see, Paul knew the temptation even for churches to become distracted by many of the things around them, especially in the ebb and flow and in the pressures of life and culture that is being placed upon the church. And he says, don't lose focus while you're walking, while you're building, and you're attempting to grow, even as a church. See, the Lord wants to be the central object of our attention and our affection. He wants to be adored by you. He wants to be firmly built into the structures of your life. And he wants us to be centered on Christ. In everything that we do, let's not lose our focus of being a Christ-centered people.